This is a frequently asked question from Math 1530, Probability and Statistics from Module 5. A company claims that the mean monthly residential electricity consumption in a certain region is more than 860 kilowatt hours. You want to test this claim. You find that a random sample of 61 residential customers has a mean monthly consumption of 890 kilowatt hours. Assume the population standard deviation is 130 kilowatt hours. At the alpha level of 0.05, can you support the claim? Okay, the level of significance is the alpha level. I just want to mention that. And before we get started setting up the null and alternative hypothesis here, I want to mention what type of test we're going to use. We're going to use the z-test because we're given the population standard deviation and our sample size is large enough to satisfy the central limit theorem. The central limit theorem says if you have a sample size larger than 30, then the distribution of the sample mean will be approximately normal. So we can use the normal bell curve. Okay, so let's set up the null and alternative hypothesis. Well, how did I do that? Based on the wording, I read this carefully, and it says that the mean is more than 860. So the wording more than does not have the equal sign, so that had to be the alternative. It also said that was the claim, so I wrote the claim here. The null always has the equal sign, so and it's the opposite statement. So this is the null that it's less than or equal to 860. So that's how I set up the null and the alternative. Next, we want to find the critical values. To do that, you look at the alternative hypothesis, and if it says more than, it's going to be a right-tailed test. If it says less than, it's going to be a left-tailed test. If it says not equal to or different, then it's a two-tailed test. Since our problem has the alternative as more than, then I know it's a right-tailed test, which means I have exactly one critical value, and that critical value is going to be positive. The next thing I'm going to do is look at the alpha level. The alpha level we're given is 0.05. So that means I need to find a critical value that has an area to its right, since it's a right-tailed test, of 0.05. We can use the calculator to find this critical value. We can use the inverse norm function to find a z when we know the area, but it has to be the area to the left of z when we enter it in the calculator. So remember that all the area under the bell curve adds to 1. So that means to the left of z, the area would have to be 0.95, because 0.95 plus 0.05 is 1. So in the calculator, I'm going to pull it up. I'll walk you through it on the calculator. Go to the inverse norm function, so it's second distribution. Inverse norm, the area to the left is 0.95. The mean for the standard normal curve is always 0, and the standard deviation is always 1. There is our critical value, 1.64. So what I've done here is I've drawn out the standard normal curve. I've labeled where the mean is, and it goes out 3 standard deviations to the right, 3 standard deviations to the left, and I've located where the critical value would be. And the area to its right is the rejection region, since this is a right-tailed test. What that means is if our test statistic turns out to be in this rejection region, we will reject the null. Okay. Just a word about the notation. Z sub C stands for the critical value, and Z stands for the test statistic. Here's the formula for z. And it's x bar minus mu divided by sigma divided by the square root of n. Now let me show you how to locate those items from the wording in the problem. Well, the sample size is pretty easy. You just look at the sample size at 61. Now, to figure out the sample mean, you have to read the sentences carefully and look for where it tells you it's the sample mean. So here it says you find that a random sample of 61 residential customers has a mean, so sample mean of 890. So that's our sample mean. The population mean, it doesn't just come right out and say what the population mean is, but when we set up the null in the alternative, the equal sign goes with the null. So this is the population mean equals 860. So that's where I came up with using 860 as the population mean. And of course, we're given the population standard deviation is 130. Okay, so we're going to put this in the calculator to get our test statistic. So it's 890 minus 860 divided by 130 divided by the square root of 61. You can do this all in one step on the calculator. Let me show you how to type it in. So put parentheses around the numerator. So 890 minus 860, close parentheses, divided by, now open parentheses, 130 divided by the square root of 61, close parentheses, and hit enter. There is our test statistic, 1.80. When you type this in the calculator, be very careful to watch your parentheses or you'll get the wrong answer. Okay. So our test statistic ends up falling in the rejection region, because 1.80 is greater than 1.64, which means we're going to reject the null. So our interpretation here is we can support the claim at the 5% significance level that the mean monthly residential electric consumption in a certain region is greater than 860 kilowatt hours. I hope this example helps everyone. Good luck.